We're going to do another demonstration of the polarity integration process, the release process, emotional clearing, self-actualization technique. What else is it? Emotional release work, limiting beliefs release work, know thyself sort of thing. And also it's a process where you dichotomies, where you find there's opposites within you. You feel one way and you feel another way at the same time. You want to this, but you want to do the opposite. You believe one thing, but you believe the opposite. There's a part of you that believes the opposite. So there's this internal conflict going on, and sometimes we want to express ourselves, but the emotion is negative, so we don't want to express our negative shit, and so we hold it in. And too much of this holding in for too long makes for a sad situation. We don't feel as alive as we used to be. We're more alive when we are able to express how we feel in the moment. But because so many yicky things have been going on recently, in the last 20, 30 years, a few thousand years actually, but for people like us, this has been very clear in the last 10, 20 years. It's getting really strange. So while we're trying to work and get ourselves into the light and the higher vibration, release our fears and anger and hate and all that, and be more loving, we go, how can I do that when all that crazy shit's going on? So this is a process that I developed. It's got several names, but it's all part of the Laughing Buddha technique or the Laughing Buddha process, because it has to do with the technique will get you to laugh or chuckle, and that's basically the point of the process. It's the Buddha aspect is the enlightenment. So you have a laugh and a chuckle. You have a realization. You go, I get that. It's about yourself, so it's self-realization. So there you are, Laughing Buddha. Ha, ha, ha. Okay, so these are demonstrations. This is the first one you've seen. These are demonstrations of how to do the technique on yourself. I do it with my cute little camera mirror image thing back and forth. You don't need to do that way, but it makes it a little more fun. So we're going to start a process here. It's about something that I think most people have in common. It has to do with a loved one, someone you loved, and they got away. You know, and so I'm going to be reaching back into my past here for this particular. I've never done this one, so it seems like it would be a good time to do it as a demonstration. So I'm going to be talking about someone that I've loved very, very much, but that relationship is no longer. Okay, so I'm going to be a good cop, or I'm going to be the good guy. I'm going to speak about this relationship that I had, always in the positive, kindness, love, decency, compassion, say good things, express good emotions. Now, sometimes it may be sarcastic, but that's okay. We just want to say the right words. And try to keep it in the light, you know, good decent things. And my other self, Darth Ritchie, what we're going to do there, where's my little camera thing? Here we go. So Rich here, you tell him what you're going to do about this. Okay, well, I'm going to take the negative side, I get to and only focus on the pain, the hate, the anger, the resentment, that sort of thing, because that's what's built up over the years, and I haven't really expressed it all that much to anyone, especially not the girl. So as demonstrations go, I wanted to find something more real for you guys, you know, because you're not going to have the same issues I have in the big picture, but a lot of people will have the resentment and the pain connected with a lost loved one. I don't mean lost, drop dead loved one, you know, died. I mean they dumped you, kind of lost loved one. Or you screwed it up and you dumped her or him. It doesn't matter. But so that's basically the introduction to the process. So, Rich, why don't you take it from here, and people can learn by watching how it works. Okay? Okay. Yeah, okay. So here we go. So the girl, if I say a name, it's going to be a, it's not going to be a real name. I'm not going to say any names at all, to protect the innocent. But there was this girl. I fell in love with her, and I'm not even going to say when. You know, it's, it just keeps it completely anonymous. After all, just for the record, I am married, and it's not my wife we're talking about. So she knows about the this, you know. But that said, I love that girl. I loved her then, and I love her now. I really I had the most profound dream experience with her. Just pure love, man. I've never had anything like that happen before. So whenever I think about her, I just feel all warm and fuzzy and love and light. Yeah, you're full of shit once again, my friend. Okay, now I have a whole lot to say. You know, it's like this, but the way this process works, if you have a laugh or a chuckle, you're supposed to ask the question. And this, go ahead, Rich. You ask me the question that every time there's a laugh or chuckle, this is the question. Yeah. Rich, can you revisit the thought that inspired that laugh or chuckle? Okay. Yeah, I was just saying you were full of shit again. You must be full of shit because that's the same realization I had last time, isn't it? Okay, he'll explain what just happened. Okay, what just happened is that we had the PC, the person coached. I guess we're coaching each other on this one. But Rich over here, he revisited the thing that made the thought that made him laugh or chuckle, that inspired the laugh or chuckle. And what that does is put our attention once again on the thing, the specific thing that caused him to chuckle in the first place. Now, the first time he laughed or chuckled, he may not have had a realization, or he may not have noticed the thing that was being realized. But when you have the, when you revisit the laugh or chuckle, you get to once again inspect exactly what you thought that made you laugh or chuckle. And usually that thought in itself is a part of or the entire realization that you're having. And it's the realization which is the enlightenment, which is the Buddha part of the laughing Buddha thing. So it's all about realizations and releasing the energy. So we just released some energy on the subject of this girl I fell in love with. And I haven't, of course, gotten all the pain off and out. Okay, so this is just a demonstration of how it worked. Did I explain that okay? Yeah, you did pretty good. Yeah, my thought was that yeah, you're full of shit. And what I mean is, when I look at it deeper, it's like to always talk in the positive about something when it just stirs up. A lot of times, it just stirs up the negative stuff underneath. So I think it's very, very healthy to just you know, say it like it is. You know, get it out of your chest, out of your system, and release it. Again, not in the on the world. You don't go telling everybody in the world, you know, your negative stuff that you have to say. That's not the point of this. This is having a safe environment and a process or procedure where you can get in touch with your negative energy and express it and release it so that it doesn't harm the environment and it releases and it's basically integrated or discharged and goes back into balance with the universe. What do you think of that? Well, now I'm thinking you're kind of full of something. Well, what was the thought that you just had that inspired your laugh or chuckle, Rich? Well, I was looking at what you just said, and I go, right, once again. So, obviously, Rich here, as much as he likes to teach and share, both of us like to teach and share here, there's some deep-seated things that we feel like we're full of shit. And that would be because we don't feel like we've really got all the answers. And we, right now, we're just trying to share some techniques that you can use to release your stuff. How's that? Okay? That's fine, dude. Let's wrap this up. Keep it under 15 minutes, and maybe we'll come back and do another one. Because, in fact, we really just got started talking about the girlfriend. We really didn't. I didn't say any of my negative, icky stuff. But actually, I didn't have to. It kind of fumbled up. I'm okay. So I'm done for now on talking about that. So let's just wrap this up really quick and cut loose, okay? Want to? Yeah, good idea. Okay, thank you for watching, and thanks for doing this with me, Rich, and releasing your stuff, and we'll talk later. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Hi, Jake. This is Jake. Hi. Rocky. Okay, bye-bye.